Less of a sesh on flexible working. So flexible working is a way of working that suits employees' needs. For example, it could be working from home or change start and end times. The critical thing is if you ask to have flexible working, you must have worked for an employer for at least 26 weeks, so half a year, to make that request. And that request is called the statutory application. And businesses must look at it in a reasonable manner. If they look at it in a reasonable manner and decide they want to go ahead with allowing employees to have flexible working, the advantages of this could be increased motivation, increased productivity, lower absenteeism, higher staff retention, and hopefully in the long term, lower recruitment costs, because their workers are happy, they're more motivated, they want to stay because the employer is being flexible to their needs. Closely related to flexible working is job sharing and zero-hour contracts. Let's quickly go through those. So job sharing is when two or more employees share one full-time job within a business. The general advantages of this is that it might be that those employees are otherwise unable to do the full-time hours, so the business is able to get those skills. And it might be that the two employees actually have different skill sets between them that makes them together as one time, as one full-term employee, even more productive. However, disadvantages of job sharing, well, there could be communication issues here. There needs to be really effective communication between those employees to ensure they get it done right and they are actually productive. And also, it could be that they need to make sure that they share their workload accordingly. And if they fail to, it could be demotivating and it could lead to problems. On the other side, zero-hour contracts. So zero-hour contracts is a special type of contract where an employer is not obliged to give a minimum level of hours to the worker, a minimum level of working hours. The advantages of this, so it's flexible to the business to have these zero-hour contracts and possibly to the workers themselves, to the employees. Other advantages is it helps the business increase their workforce hours, their workforce capacity when they need to. For example, for a seasonal period such as Christmas, if they're a retail outlet, they can increase those hours beyond zero, and that allows them to have a cost-effective way of handling with seasonal fluctuations, as opposed to the alternative, which could be to have to offer full-time or part-time contracts, being permanent contracts, and that's much more expensive. On the other side, it demotivating for workers if they have zero-hour contracts. There's arguments about that. And also the fact that because they're on zero-hour contracts, it's likely that the employer is going to give them training, and that could be even more demotivating because training is, of course, expensive. So that accentuates the demotivating point. And also employers that are using zero-hour contracts too much, well, there could be ethical concerns there with their ethical issues. I hope that helps. And I'll see you at the next session.